Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 4. This is Section 9.3, Problem number 4. It says a study of 400 new Chevy pickups revealed that 80 of the trucks had warranty work done that exceeded $1,000. Construct a 90% confidence interval for the proportion of Chevy pickups that will require warranty work that will exceed $1,000 in value. So this is a confidence interval for a population proportion. So the formula for that type of confidence interval is p hat plus or minus the square root of p hat times 1 minus p hat over n times z sub c. So that's the formula we're going to have to fill in and compute. So part of that formula is p hat. What is p hat? It's our estimate of the population proportion, which is r, the number of successful results, over n, the total number of trials. So in this case, r, the number of successful results, is 80. Well, there's a case where you'd rather not succeed. It means your new truck doesn't have to have warranty work. But there were 80 that needed the warranty work out of 400 altogether. So let's make that into a decimal. So with your calculator, you can do 80 divided by 400 equals. And the calculator will tell you that it is 0.2. So that's p hat. So now that we know p hat is 0.2, let's start filling in our confidence interval formula. So the p hat will be 0.2 plus or minus the square root of p hat, so 0.2, times 1 minus p hat, 1 minus 0.2, over n. N is the size of our sample, so in this case it's 400. Times z sub c, the confidence coefficient. So we have a little chart that tells us for the different levels of confidence what the confidence coefficient should be. So for this problem, it's 90%, and the little chart says the z sub c for 90% would be 1.645. So now the formula's filled in, now we have to start doing the math. You have to start with your work in parentheses and the square root and get that out of the way first. So we'll have 0.2 plus or minus the square root of 0.2 times 1 minus 0.2 is 0.8, and that's over 400. That's all under the square root. The 400 is included in being under the square root. And times 1.645. So now, if I multiply the numerator under my square root 0.2 times 0.8, it'll be 0.16. So that'll give me 0.2 plus or minus the square root of 0.16 over 400 times 1.645. So next thing I can do is do this division, 0.16 divide by 400, which you'd probably want to do with your calculator. So that'll give me 0.2 plus or minus the square root of, when you divide 0.16 divided by 400, your calculator will tell you it comes out to 0.0004. That's the value under the square root. So I haven't done the square root yet. So I'll do that in a minute. The 1.645 is still at the end of the formula. So now let's go ahead and take that square root. Again, your calculator will tell you pretty quickly it's 0.02. So I have 0.2 plus or minus, the square root's done now, 0.02 times 1.645. So now I can go ahead and multiply 0.02 times 1.645. So I have 0.2 plus or minus 0.0329. That's the result you'll get when you multiply. So now that I have one value after my plus and minus, I can split my interval into a separate minus and a separate plus. So the low end of my interval will be 0.2 minus 0.0329. And the upper end will be 0.2 plus 0.0329. The same numbers, one has a minus between the numbers and the other has a plus. So the low end of my interval, 0.2 minus 0.0329, will be 0.1671. And the upper end of the interval, 0.2 plus 0.0329, will be 0.2329. So that I am now 90% confident that 0.1671 to 0.2329 is an interval that contains the true proportion of new Chevy pickups that would require some type of warranty work, $1,000 or more. So within round off, you're maybe say 16.75% almost to maybe about 23.25% probability.